Hi there. Hope everyone's doing well. This side, Amanda with you. From now on, I'll be presenting these informative videos with you guys on this channel. Alright. So, today we will learn what, and how to, assign the annual degradation losses in Pvsyst. We have covered all the loss components of Pvsyst in this series. Link is in the description. Please watch other videos in this series as well, to have a complete idea on PV system losses. And, for the new viewers who are here for the first time, please hit the subscribe and like button. We will keep bringing such useful and resourceful content to you every week. So, please subscribe. And press the bell icon to get all the notifications. We post compact and useful contents there, for professionals and students who are new into this field. Please keep following us there as well. Thank you guys for your support so far. Your likes and comments meant a lot for us. So, let's start. So, first, let's discuss about few basics. What is annual photovoltaic degradation? Here, annual photovoltaic module degradation refers to the gradual decrease in the efficiency of a solar panel over time. This decrease can be caused by various factors, such as exposure to the elements, aging of materials, and accumulation of dust and dirt. On average, most solar panels experience a degradation rate of around 0.5% to 0.7% per year, meaning that after 20 years, the efficiency of a solar panel may have declined by 10% to 14%. Next, we need to know that why this annual photovoltaic degradation is so important. The reason is that this particular factor directly impacts the performance and the efficiency of your solar panels over time. By understanding the rate of degradation, you can make informed decisions about the size of your solar panel system, the type of panels to use, and the expected return on investment. Now, let's see how we consider this loss in Pvsyst for energy yield simulation. We go step by step. In the detail loss section of Pvsyst, the 7th tab is dedicated for solar modules annual degradation. This section, aging, helps you to predict any year's generation in Pvsyst. So, first, check the option on the top that says uses in simulation. Now, if you want to simulate the system for 11th year of operation, then change the value to 11 in this year box. And we strongly suggest that you should not change anything else here, as these are very sensitive, non-linear, mathematical calculations. And changing without having firm idea will result in error in the simulation report. In fact, on the right side, at the bottom section, you can actually assign the performance warranty provided by the module manufacturer. This way, you can accurately predict the year-on-year degradation. So, for an example, we want to simulate the first year energy yield for the PV system that we have designed. Now, as per module datasheet and warranty document, we are setting these performance warranty values for the specific years. And just save the details by clicking OK and run the simulation. And that's it. By assigning the value of annual PV degradation in Pvsyst, you can get a more accurate simulation of your solar panel system's performance over time and make informed decisions about your energy needs. After the simulation, you can locate the annual degradation losses here in the loss diagram of the simulation report. So, that's it for today, guys. Hope you get a good idea of annual degradation losses of solar PV modules with Pvsyst. Our next session will be on the system unavailability and assigning it in Pvsyst modeling. Keep subscribe and enjoy the learning process. Do not forget to like, comment, and please share this session with your friends. Do follow our channel, Minutes to Energy, on YouTube for more upcoming and interesting videos on solar PV system. Like, how to start a solar business, how to design solar PV system, and solar panel manufacturing process. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next session.